Hello and welcome to livealittlehigher.com. This week we continue with our class on Shalom Bayit, Peace in the Home, with the book of Rabbi Itzhak Ginsberg, The Mystery of Marriage. Last week we were speaking about the importance to praise our spouse, how important it is that we always have encouraging words to give and that we see the potential in the other and we see the goodness in the other. Rabbi Itzhak Ginsberg stresses very, very hard the importance of the way in which we speak to each other, the way we relate to each other. Speech is paramount to a shalom bayit, to a good relationship between spouses. Many relationships are full of bad feelings and inner rage because the couple doesn't know how to communicate in a beautiful way. And Jewish religion and mysticism teaches us how our words can really come to build up a person or destroy a person. And we see it with people who have very low self-esteem. And when they go to therapy, they come to see that when they were children, they were admonished and told they were stupid and told they were good for nothing. And the parents never praised them, never told them they loved them. And this creates a very broken person. So we can really do a lot with our words. We can really build a whole person up with our words. So this week, we will be talking about words of control and direction, and then we're gonna be talking about words of gratitude. And this comes after praise. Everything is in its right order. So words of control and direction are talking about that sometimes we have to ask things from our spouse or from anybody in our lives. And the way in which we ask people to do things for us is very important. So we should never ask in a way where we make others feel like we're on top of them. And he says here, if one phrase instructions as request rather than demands, both acknowledging the other person's autonomy even though he's functioning as a subordinate, and minimizes one's own authority, even though he's functioning as a superior, one will generally elicit a positive response. So when you have to ask for something, if you make yourself too big, the reaction of the other person is not gonna be good. They're gonna feel resentful, they're gonna feel that they're being taken advantage of, and that they're not being acknowledged. So we have, when we're asking for favors from other people or we wanna demand something, really, we should really make it not a demand, but we should make it like a request. So if you need like your husband to help you out in the house, he's not a mind reader. Say it in a nice way, like say, honey, you know what, I have so much work in the house, I'm a little overwhelmed, would you mind helping me with the garbage? So that's very different than saying, honey, I'm overwhelmed, and you start screaming and you're crazy, and you say, please take the garbage out. So if you're screaming to the other person, please take the garbage out, you're like giving an order. But if you tell him with kindness and you tell him it would be so helpful for me if you help me, then the other person is gonna do it more than happily. He's gonna be, what else can I do for you? So this is very important. Also it's important, sincerity. We've talked about this word many times in different instances, and sincerity is paramount. And to truly recognize and value the other person's intrinsic worth and integrity. So when a person is helping you out in any way they can, like, value it, recognize it, don't take it for granted. And it is for this reason that this category of speech follows the previous one of praise. Because this degree of kindness, of hesed, is termed loving kindness within victory. Hesed shebenetzach. It's victory is endurance, it's resilience. In this case, it's used as victory. And the word victory also means conducting or supervising. So when a person is victorious, it's a person that knows how to delegate. He knows how to tell other people what he needs. Many people are angry inside and they keep resentment because they're expecting their husband to behave in a certain way. It's expectations. So when you have expectations and you feel entitled to a certain behavior from the other person, then it's going to be an angry relationship. So the attribute of Netzach is associated in Kabbalah with the fourth day of creation, on which God created the sun, the moon, and the stars, and God put them in the firmament of the heavens to shine on the earth, to rule over the day and the night, and to separate between light and darkness. And here we know that the true ruler over the whole world is Hashem. But he gives the luminaries, and he gives them a certain amount of control. Like he delegates to them. So the sun knows he has to shine during the day. The moon knows she has to shine during the night. And he delegates towards them. But the true person that's running the show is like a marionette show, like a puppet show. You think the little kid is gonna go. He thinks the puppets are real. But really, behind the curtain, there's a whole other thing going on. And they're the ones who are running the show. So in our lifetime, we sometimes think that we are the conductors of our life. But in reality, there's the bigger conductor, which is Hashem. It's like the axe. Might think it's chopping the tree, and it forgets there's a wood chopper holding the axe. So nonetheless, they give full autonomy to the earth and its mortal beings. They certainly do not feel they are owed anything. That's a very important thing also, that you don't feel that people owe you because you do things for them. And for they are aware that they are no more than a hatchet in the hand of the woodcutter. They are the humble servants of God, just as was Moshe Rabbeinu, the humble leader and commander of the Jewish people. So when people know their place and they know their power and they know what is expected of them, then people become humble, like an owner of a business, the boss of a business. He has a certain degree of autonomy and he has a certain amount of higher respect from the rest of the people. But if he, in his head, understands that his place was given to him by Hashem and that he has the ability to be the person he is because Hashem made him that person, then the way he's going to treat his employees is going to come from a place of humbleness and not a place of arrogance. So now we come to the words of gratitude, which are very important in a relationship. We have to be grateful to our spouse for the things they do for us. After one request has been fulfilled, care must be taken to express proper gratitude. We should always be grateful. Even if he helped us do something that you would think he should do, just be grateful. Say, thank you, honey. I really appreciate what you're doing tonight for me. It really takes a lot of work out of my schedule. I appreciate it. So, Hakaras Hatov, which is the word we use for gratitude in Hebrew, is really a huge mitzvah. And what we don't realize is that gratitude is the vessel for blessing. If a person is not grateful for what he has, and he doesn't acknowledge where this is coming from, then he has no blessing in his life. There's no bracha. So the degree of hesed is termed loving kindness within thanksgiving. Thanksgiving also, hesed shebehot. The word thanksgiving comes from the word hodu. Hodu means turkey. And this is where thanksgiving comes from, really, from the Jews. So the Hebrew word for thanksgiving is hodu, also means acknowledgement and recognition that what one has received is a gift. So if we are able to tap in our lives to our blessings, then we see everything in our lives as a gift, and really a gift from God, because the ultimate giver is Him, and He uses all of us as His shliach, as His messengers to be able to deliver this kindness to other people, then we're going to be full of gratitude. We'll never feel that we're owed anything. We never feel that we're entitled to anything. On the contrary, we're going to feel like, oh, wow, Oh wow, I have a job. Oh wow, look, I have a home. Oh wow, I can't believe Hashem has me in this place. And when you live like this, then you're always gonna be happy. There's no way not to be. And you're gonna have a beautiful relationship too. So it says here, the truest way to ensure sincerity in gratitude is to cultivate one's awareness that none of us is in fact deserving of anything. We have to understand we don't deserve anything in life. We don't deserve anything. Everything we have really is a gift from God. He gives it to us because He's kind. But we don't deserve anything. We haven't done anything to deserve anything. So, and that everything we possess or benefit from is a result of God's unmitigated kindness. So everything we are, everything we have, everything we are gonna have is really comes from the kindness of Hashem. The attribute of Hod, which is humbleness, thanksgiving, is associated in Kabbalah with the fifth day of creation, on which God created the fish and the birds. Here, for the first time, God blessed His creation, and God blessed them, saying, "Be fruitful and multiply, and fill the water in the seas, and let the birds multiply on earth." And aside from possessing mobility, the animal kingdom is distinguished from the mineral and vegetable kingdoms by its active consciousness. So animals have a consciousness. They can feel Hashem. If you don't believe me, wake up really early, you'll see the birds praising God. You'll see it. It's unbelievable. So they have a consciousness, not like ours, but they do have a consciousness and appreciation of Hashem. So our sages teach us that fish and birds possess enough consciousness to experience divine providence and continuously acknowledge their destiny as at His hands. They understand that Hashem is the ruler of the world. Imagine for a human being who has a much bigger intellect, has sometimes it's a very hard thing to understand. But animals don't even question it. And here it's saying that this is the significance of the term living being, which is the first applied to the animal kingdom. Rashi explains this term to mean that animals possess vitality, which is synonymous in Kabbalah with consciousness. So any living being that moves has a consciousness. The ability and willingness to receive gratefully is what elicits the gift. So what opens the vessel, the bracha, what I told you at the beginning of this class, is gratitude. The desire to give or to fulfill requests is deeply rooted in every individual, since giving gives a person a sense of worthiness. So a person that is able to give is a person that feels that he's worth something. A person that doesn't give anything feels worthless. This is why you see so many elderly people volunteering in hospitals and volunteering, because at an old age, sometimes people come to feel like they're a burden to their kids, they're a burden to society. But if they're giving, they're always gonna feel that they're worthy. It's so important. So by articulating one's appreciation, therefore the recipient becomes the giver, and the giver is the recipient of the validation. So when you're giving, really, the hesed comes from the receiver. Because if you don't have anybody to give to, then you would never feel appreciated and you would never feel worthy. So it's really the recipient, the one that gives you your self-esteem, the one that gives you that feeling of worthiness. And thus validate that the giver is encouraged to give further or comply with additional requests. So when a person is giving and the recipient is grateful, this encourages that person to continue giving. When you're giving to somebody and that person doesn't appreciate it, doesn't even say thank you, then one day you say, is it really worth it to give to this person? Like, I'm wasting my time. And the Torah says that one who gives a morsel of bread to a child should inform his mother. Like, when you give a gift, it's important that the receiver knows that you're giving them a gift. Not because of you. Not because you need the gratitude. You do need it at a certain point. But the person that receives needs more to be grateful and say thank you, because this is what gives them the bracha of receiving. If a person is not grateful, he'll never get anything. And you see, people who are ungrateful are angry, they're resentful, they're always, they don't have a bracha in their life. It's like they're dead. So we need to make it conscious for the person that is receiving, that he's receiving. It's a hesed you're giving them, it's a kindness. So here in any coupling process, Kabbalah teaches that the male position is that of the netzach, the command, while the female position is that of the hot, the gratitude. So in Kabbalah, the woman is the receiver and the man is the giver. Like, he's the one that gives the seed, and the woman is the one that receives that seed. But what happens, that it makes a baby. The baby grows in the mother, and then she's the one that's giving back the baby. So the giving and receiving should be like a harmonious dance. One gives, the other one receives, the one that receives gives, then the other one receives. It should go back and forth. It's not, it shouldn't be something that is one-way street, okay? And here, to finish off, which is very important to understand, is that according to the Talmud, a Jew should begin his day by reciting the Berachot. It's very important to accustom ourselves to do blessings in the morning. Very important. Even if you don't pray anything, just buy a siddur and do the morning blessings. It will take you exactly 3 minutes. And this is because the vessel, you need to create a vessel. You need to create a keli so the blessing will fall inside. Like, if you don't create a vessel, Hashem has all these blessings for you, but if you don't have where to receive them, they're gonna just be thrown away. So the vessel is gratitude, and when we wake up and the first bracha we make, the first blessing we make is Modei Ani Lefaneha. Thank you, Hashem, living and eternal King, for you have kindly restored my soul to me. Your faith is abundant. This is the first thing we do when we open our eyes. We're praising Hashem, we're thanking Him for making us be alive again, to return our souls to ourselves. So all human endeavor requires God's blessing to be successful, and the human effort is no more than the vessel which man prepares to receive God's blessing. So God is the giver of the blessing, and our job is to create the vessel, the keli, so the blessing can come in. And just as God is the ultimate source of blessing, so is He the ultimate object of all thanksgiving. So yes, when we thank somebody for our blessings, for whatever goodness He did for us, in reality, we're creating a vessel. But ultimately, the kindness comes from Hashem. So if anybody ever does a favor to you or does something nice for you, really, he's just a messenger from God. The true giver is God. He's just the person that God chose at that moment, because that person has a merit to give so he can receive the gratitude. That person has the merit to be a vessel, and God is giving you the gift, okay? So whenever one thanks someone for a gift received or for a favor done, his gratitude should carry the awareness that he owes God thanks as well. And sincerely thanking others is in fact a good way to develop a sense of indebtedness to God. And so we say, by cultivating awareness of one's indebtedness to God, one elicits his blessing. And Rabbi Ginsberg says, and he stresses it here, that couples that have not been blessed with children yet should really work very hard on their gratitude. It's very hard when you're suffering to find what it's being sent to you. But try to look at any good thing that happens to you. Like, if you're in the hospital and you're going through a treatment and the nurse is nice, thank you, Hashem, you send me a nice person to take care of me. Thank you, Hashem, you send me a good doctor. Thank you, Hashem, that I have a future. I can look for something. I can do something about it. Always say thank you, because thank you will open the doors to all your brachas, to all your blessings. So I leave you here. I wish you a good, beautiful week, and that you should have a lot of reasons to be grateful for, and also a lot of people that you can do things for. Okay? And live a little higher. Thank you.